Yeah, good morning students. Welcome back to our last class, that is in the e-business. We are going to complete our syllabus today. The topic that is MVAS, Mobile Value Added Services, and what are its market? Now, Mobile Value Added Service is a famous term in telecommunication industry used to describe non-core services, broadly, all services which are beyond the standard voice, data calls, SMS, MMS, and fax transactions. So, core services means what here? Core services are nothing but basic services, or support services, or complementary services. These are the core services of a value-added service. Now, see in the what will happen here in this. Basic services, when your mobile has not working, if it is gone hack or this, the applications are not opening, or it is got affected with the virus, or it got some technical problem in it. So these people will help you to solve the basic services, and they will give the support to you, and it will come to the support services. And sometimes some mobile phones or some digital phones are some unit or commodity or the product will be in the complementary situation. So they will solve all these services. So this will comes under the core services. Now, conceptually, telecommunications companies use value-added services to improve the value of the standard service offering and to spur subscribers to use their primary services more and drive up the average revenue per user. So what is happening here? So it is helping to bring the standard among the customers so that the value can be added to the services. Now, here is a basic definition. Definition of value-added service is nothing but a non-core service, that is all services beyond standard voice calls or SMS and data products, and it is enable mobile operators to develop additional revenue streams and can be used in any service industry for services available at little or no cost or to promote their primary business. Now, this one is here we are having the list of value-added services. What are the services you will get in the value-added? First, they'll give you the training, how to use and what to use and what are the things you should have to be very careful. Telephony add-ons will be there, free information will be there, and customer services will be there. And there will be warranties will also be there. So sometimes they will give some warranties will be there for their apps or for their unique terms. So they will provide, the companies will provide according to their limited resources. Now, coming to the last one, that is security. This is the next one, that is how the security threats arising from mobile commerce. See, what is happening nowadays, the cyber crime has been found around since there was this cyber world to abuse with criminals stealing information, stealing money, stealing identities, shutting down the businesses by providing the fake identities or the password or OTP. These are the things that are going on and compromising security all over the world. It is going in the international level. Now, next thing, the risk of cyber crime grows ever larger on mobile devices. So, comparing with our personal computers, the cyber crimes are taking place more on our mobile devices, which criminals are increasing, eyeing on a compromising new sources of revenue. So what is happening? These criminals, the theft or the hackers or the criminals, we can say they are keeping an eye on our sources of revenue. That means they want to generate the sources, like they are taking, they are just getting the information, click on this, you'll get some kind of bonus, or the spring will be there. Sometimes you'll get an ad pop-ups that if you click here, you'll get a gift like that. When we are clicking on it, they are taking our data, personal data, and what is our bank account, where our amount has been kept, in which bank, in which branch, and what is our password, so that they'll send one, or they'll give a one call to us that we are calling from XYZ bank of your branch. And I'm just sending you a message, just give me the OTP so that we want to verify it for the sake of verifications, like that they are bringing the fraudness in the society. So we have to be very careful. So all these things will come to another cyber crime. Now, here, this is the one more thing. Here is number a routing. What do you mean by routing? A routing is a collection of computer software, typically malicious, designed to enable access to a computer or an area of its software that is not otherwise allowed. For example, an unauthorized user. So he's an unauthorized user. He's going to connect your computer or the software and often mask its existence to the software or to other software. If you see here in this picture, this is totally showing what are the drivers, ring 1, ring 2, blue color. So from least privilege to most privilege, we have to be very careful with these things. How the applications will come in which ring, where the drivers are coming in which ring, and where the kernel is coming in which ring, all these things are here. We have to be very careful while downloading the apps and when we are giving or uploading the information or data to that particular app. Now, risky QR codes are there. So what is happening here? Sometimes if you scan this, you'll get a free Wi-Fi or free coupon or token like that, or we'll send you the app like they are giving some instructions. So we have to be very careful. So what is happening? The security risks that comes with the use of QR codes are that the QR code is useful, basically used for making the calendars or contacts or even credit card information available on the criminals. So what is happening with the help of when you are scanning that code? So what's happening? The criminals are going to hack, or they are getting the information available within your credit card or contact numbers. And what they are doing, they are stealing your Facebook, Google and other password and posting without your knowledge or permission. So what is happening? This QR codes are, we have to be very careful. Whenever if you go, we have to scan it and it is sending you the message or fulfilling your requirement. But sometimes what is happening, these criminals fellows, what they will do, they can steal your Google or password or Facebook account and they will utilize without your knowledge or permission. And tracking your location for criminal purpose. Not only that, for purpose only they will track your location and criminal purpose is taking place. You won't do, you are not aware of those, but that fellow will be involved in that and they are utilizing it. He is using your passwords or ID, what it may be. So this is the one picture where you can identify. Person is scanning the QR code. So unnecessary, unwantedly, we should not have to scan the code. If you are scanning, what will happen, that criminals persons will generate the data which is there in our mobile phone, like some password or the hidden account numbers or contacts numbers or the Google's or Gmail accounts. They can open it and they can utilize without your knowledge and permission also. So the software, they'll connect to the software. Now, next one is theft of digital certificates. What is happening nowadays, our digital signatures will be there. You will keeping one digital signature along with your mobiles or within your laptop. So these hackers are criminal persons. What they are doing, they are simply thefting or hacking or taking away your digital signatures and digital password. Or whatever it may be, the organizations where you keep on digital certificates where you are keeping. So these fellows can hack your certificates and they can utilize or they can misuse it. Now, next one is smishing. Smishing is nothing but it is a kind of advertisement where you will get in your mobile phone and like in a form of a message that you have just won a $100 gift card. Please click here to claim your gift. So what we will do, people who are not aware of this cybercrime, just they'll click on that and they will, the criminal will hack their data. What are the informations or data will be there, it will be gone. So the big business people's business persons, what they will do, they are not going to keep their things unnecessary in front of the public. So we should have to be very careful while doing the utilizing the smartphone or the devices. Now, next one is social engineering. So in social engineering, what is happening? Unnecessary fraud passwords will come, or security or influence or pretext or access will be there. You are logging and that fellow will spying you. They will come to know, like how you expect when the cricket match is going on in the stadium. They are watching to you, what you are doing, where you are going, how you are going, when you are using the cell phone, at what time you are sleeping. So everything now, the digital or the 5G or the 4G generation has been increased. How the hi-fi technology has been created to bring the frauds. In the last classes also we discussed how it work. Now, next one is unsecured Wi-Fi. See what will happen if you unnecessarily don't share or take the Wi-Fi. What will happen? I don't have my internet in my mobile, so I'm taking the Wi-Fi from XYZ person. Then he will ask the password. You are sharing your password. So what is happening? That fellow can take out the information or the details what is there in your mobile phones. For example, you may have kept your ATM card or debit card, credit card password, or your calendars or important information or meetings, or sometimes you have kept your digital signature in that, or you may have kept your account number in that, or your bank details, mobile banking or e-banking, what it may be. So with the help of this Wi-Fi, they can come to know what sort of things you are having in your mobile phone or in your device. So they can theft that, they can take the information and they can utilize without your knowledge and permission also. Now, next one is virus and malware. See, we are having different types of malware like Trojan horse or remote access or worm or keylogger, virus, adware, rootkit, spyware, ransomware, what it may be. So nowadays many people are installing some app like in the form of antivirus, like McAfee. In the starting during 2010 period, it has told that and McAfee is very good for antivirus, but many people are not aware that the hackers are utilizing, in the name of your antivirus, they are going in your mobile phones in depth knowledge and they are stealing the password or the details, and they are taking the, they are hacking the encryption. Encryptions are nothing but the numbers, how the system will work, the DOS command. They are stealing that. So one more thing is here, if you see in this picture, how see all the apps has been got virus. All your files are not opening in the laptop or in the PC or mobile, or your photos, pictures, videos, details, all the things has been corrupted or they has been blocked. So what happened at last? The virus has attacked your file. So we have to be very careful while downloading the antivirus app also. So we have to be very careful. Next one, crimeware. See what is happening? Crimeware is nothing but it is an computer program or set of programs designed expressly to facilitate illegal activity online. Many spyware programs, browser hijackers and key loggers can be considered crimeware, although only those use illicitly. So if you see this picture, what is happening? Crimeware is taking place just for the sake of the fun or for the sake of earning shortcut money. Nowadays many people, youngsters, are involving this shortcut money. And if I work for 1 hour, I will get 2 to 3 lakhs or some crores of rupees. So how, from where they are getting? Just they are utilizing their knowledge, or they may be utilizing their crimeware app and they are stealing the data or details of some unknown person, or like in the form of the ATM cards or credit card or digital signatures or digital certificates or account in mobile mark banking, what it may be. Now, next one is encryption hacking. See, nowadays what is happening, many people are going in the deep knowledge of the IT and they are hijacking or hacking the encryptions. Encryptions are what? It is nothing but internet protocol language. What is happening here? The systems will be there. 0-1 will work in the form of the new binary systems. With the help of this, your system is working. So they are hacking the knowledge, language, and they are utilizing the data. So we have to be very careful while utilizing this. And the last one is nothing but electronic eavesdropping. See, telephone eavesdropping means what are the problems you may have, other risk factors you can have. Digital systems should be there, original throat to be secure, digital stream can be recorded and converted to analog and speech. So what is happening? The conference call host will be there. So when you are speaking, that digital will be there. They are hacking and they are handset will be related. It will be get connected to another what we can say, another devices also. See, if you see in this picture how I am just utilizing my laptop, but how it is connecting to other. So the to whom I am speaking, what I am speaking, what the things are going to be recorded, and the person who is sitting a distance above, he can utilize that backs hacking and mobile phone interception, and he can also listen what I am speaking, or the data will be got recorded and can be sent. So small smartphone also getting hacked. So this is the information where I want to share with you that we have to be very careful while using all these crime rates of the cyber crime. So by this we have just completed our syllabus in e-business. Thank you, have a nice day, best of luck for you all. Our semester internals and externals.